no place to go. No place to go. Darling, no place to go. No place to go.
This is Mr. P on the beat. I'm here with Mr. Charles Peart, and exciting times, exciting people, exciting information that we're going to talk about today. This individual, I'm telling you, you'll be blown away. So let's get this started. Charles.
Listening.
Yeah, how you doing?
Very good.
So, a man of the town. I'm hearing a lot of wonderful things about
okay.
In the back end.
Okay. For example, tell me.
For example, I heard you have this wonderful, outside of the entertainment stuff
yeah.
that you do and, you know, the contributions that you've given to this community in Toronto, where, you know, very little people know behind
yeah.
the scenes
yeah.
your influence. But outside of that, I've been told about a youth initiative that you've got going on.
Yes, that's one of my greatest passion is in regard to a school that I funded myself and built in Jamaica with the help of the locals. My greatest interest is to bring awareness and education to those who are forgotten. So I try to keep it very, very hush-hush because I don't want to take the glory away from those kids.
So Charles, tell me a little bit about the foundation. What is the name of the foundation?
It's called Global Students Foundation. Building school, buying books, supplies, lunch programs, and other stuff to educate them as well, and paying the teachers. So that's what Global Students is about. Because of my mother, I decided that I want to provide a service for these kids who have no money. It's very rural, and they're young kids, and I figured education is necessary because we live in a country where we can afford it. But in Jamaica, where it is really, really rural. And the kids are running around and they have no education, nothing going for them. And I figured I'll take it upon myself to give back to my mother's community.
So when did you know that it was something that you wanted to engage in?
Well, I would say it was about 15 years ago, but the fact is that I went to visit my grandmother at the time. And being that they have a lot of land up there, I figured, well, having these kids running around and not doing anything, I figured it would be something to give back to the community.
Right.
And the fact that my kids at the time were spoiled brats, they got everything. Seeing these kids without nothing, not going to school, I figured it would be something to do and give. And that's basically what I've done.
So tell me a little bit about your upbringing.
Well, I would say I can't get in too much. I'm pretty shy when it comes to my upbringing. Most of my upbringing is basically a discipline by my grandmother, her grandparents who were very strict Jamaicans,
right, yeah,
shoveling back and forth from America, Canada, and going into Jamaica. It's a matter of getting whipped. You know what I mean? And
I know it sounds harsh,
yeah.
But, you know, where we come from in Jamaica, yeah. I mean,
yeah.
you know, parenting is taken very seriously.
Yeah.
Very seriously. Honestly, these Canadian kids, they have it easy.
Yes.
They have it yeah. way too easy, I think, perhaps.
Yeah.
I don't know. But,
yeah.
yeah.
Well, basically, that's what that is.
Yeah.
Right. So part of that upbringing, it creates discipline. It creates, for me, learning that when you have nothing, you learn to appreciate when you have something. And so my part of that upbringing is from that was instilled in me because of my grandmother, how to give back and how to be kind. And going back and being successful, being here in Canada, and through my business, I've learned that it's good to give back to society. And that's basically where my head is at right now at this moment. It's not about me or what I have achieved. It's all about, my focus is about the school. And having kids better educated. And so that is basically my goal. And that's one of the reasons why I'm giving this interview. I personally like to stay behind the scene, as you know, Walt, right?
Right.
So I don't.
It wasn't easy getting it out here, to be honest. And And let me tell you, this has been months in the making. So thanks for coming out.
Thank you.
Yeah.
All right. Basically, I think I appreciate that. But that's just basically why I'm here. And thank you again, Walter. I am very comfortable because of you doing it. Else I would never give this interview.
Thanks. What can we do to help the foundation?
Look in social media and find any way they can donate books or whatever they can donate. It goes directly to the school itself and also to the school board. And anyway, anyone can help. That's basically in reach me through my company website.
Awesome. And it's the Global
Student Foundation.
.com. GlobalStudentFoundation.com. You guys got that?
Thank you.
Put it up on the screen and make sure you get in touch with Charles and the Global Foundation. And do what you can. Education on a global scale is extremely important. And we now live in a global village. So, what's that saying? Teach one.
Each one teach one. Yeah.
That's it.
I think that's my motto, and I think that's what it is.
I'm actually confident that things will go extremely well with the foundation. And I'm looking forward to having an opportunity as well. And we will capture that, and you'll see some segments on that in the very near future.
Yes.
And I need a bike going back to Jamaica as well. So.
Well, of course, Walter, we'll have you down in Jamaica as well to capture some of the footage, create some footage for when we're doing our fundraising and also having lunch programs and stuff like that for the kids. We'll definitely like to have our Canadian team come down and capture some of that footage. And there are some people with Global Students behind the scene. Would not call any names now, but they've been very inspirational to, especially one particular person, will not call her name, who is basically a very influential person that have me going on camera as well. So with that said, I think Walter, you know why, and you know who I'm referring to without calling any names or having that person on camera.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Walter. Absolutely. Thank you very much for your help today, and I appreciate everything you guys have done for us and for Global Student. Thank you.
Excellent. Okay, so that's Mr. P on the beat. I'm here with Charles Peart, man of the city, a man of honor, and a man of dedication, giving back to the community in Jamaica with a Global
Student
Foundation.
Yes.
.com. Make sure, check it out. Yeah. And look forward to seeing you guys coming out and supporting the
foundation. Thank you.
Cheers.
Beautiful.